Welcome to Scottish Sovereigns on the Land and the home of No Borders Radio.
Hi, and welcome back to another episode of Leaving the Farm right here on Revolution Radio, freedomslips.com, where information never sleeps. We are a listener-supported radio station, where if you'd like to donate, please visit us at www.freedomslips.com and click on our support pages. Every little bit helps. We're simulcasting tonight on No Borders Radio in the UK. Thank you for joining us. I am sad to announce the passing of one of my most dear teachers, who has taught many, many of us, and I got word of his death today, although he passed away on March 2nd. Professor R.J. Rummel passed away on March 2nd. He's the author of, I can't even count how many books I've read, and very, very profound man. You can find his works at hawaii.edu/powerkills/welcome.html. Click around on his site. He talks about democracy being a means and method of democide, war, and truly, power kills. It breaks my heart to have lost such a dear member of our body. Without R.J. Rummel, I don't think that I would be here. I don't think that I would have the knowledge that I have without his strength, without his fortitude, and without his word and the way that he presented it. And I'm so thankful to have known him, to have been one of his students. And again, I'm deeply saddened by his loss. Tonight, I wanted to start, I'll just get right into it. Part of the demo side, demo in Greek means people. Side means to kill. Again, demo means people. Kratos in Greek means to control or possess. If you live in a democratic society, a republic, under constitutional theory, you are what it refers to as democratics, meaning to control or possess people. If you read Article 2 of the 1929 Geneva Convention, you'll find that prisoners of war are in the power of the hostile power, but not of the individual or corps who have captured them. You live under corporate governance. You're not a prisoner of war of Google. You're not a prisoner of war of IBM or Microsoft. You're a prisoner of war of the holding corporations that hold those companies inside of them. From investopedia.com, the definition of a holding company. A parent corporation, limited liability company, or limited partnership that owns enough voting stock in another company to control its policies and management. A holding company exists for the sole purpose of controlling another company, which might also be a corporation, limited partnership, or limited liability company, rather than for the purpose of producing its own goods or services. Holding companies also exist for the purpose of owning property such as real estate, patents, trademarks, stocks, and other assets. If a business is 100% owned by a holding corporation, it is called a wholly owned subsidiary. Investopedia goes on to explain holding company. One benefit of forming a holding company is that the holding company itself is protected from the losses. If one of their companies goes bankrupt, the holding company experiences a capital loss and a decline in net worth, but the bankrupt company's debtors and creditors can't pursue the holding company for remuneration. Thus, a major corporation might structure itself as a holding company with one subsidiary to own its brand name, such as the United States Incorporated, and trademarks, another to own its real estate, another to own its equipment, and others to operate each franchise. You know that as acts of enablement or state constitutions. This way, each subsidiary, as well as the holding company itself, was limited financial and legal liability. Structuring a company this way can also limit tax liability by strategically basing certain parts of the business in jurisdictions with lower tax rates, or none, if you're looking at a bank or a court. From the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, the definition of a clearinghouse, an establishment maintained by banks for settling mutual claims and accounts. Now, if a holding company holds bankrupt corporations under it, it has a clearinghouse. You know yours as the Secretary of State. From www.state.gov/T/PM/PPA/GPOI/C20213.htm. This is from the State Department. The clearinghouse is a mechanism to exchange information and coordinate activities to enhance peace operations, capacity building efforts. Caput in Greek means head, human head. The U.S. hosted the first clearinghouse meeting focused on Africa in October of 2004. Subsequent G8 Africa clearinghouse meetings were hosted by the United Kingdom and the Russian Federation in February 2006 and June 2006, as well as by Germany and Japan in 2007 and 2008. The U.S. held its first G8++ global clearinghouse in October of 2007 to enable information exchange and coordination on peace operations, capacity building efforts around the world. 46 countries and organizations participated in this initial conference. Future G8++ conferences will be held elsewhere in the world to continue this information exchange and coordination. Let's go to capacity building. The Pyongyang project has cultivated unique relationships with various North Korean organizations and universities to allow for a system of responsible engagement through capacity building initiatives. Your government went bankrupt in 1933. The Secretary of State is the clearinghouse. You live in the Pyongyang project. Through the mutual agreements with the United States and the Republic of Korea from 1953. You can find that at yale.edu.law, Yale's Law Library. Entertainment laugh here. Democratic congressman picks his ear, eats his wax on live TV during a House hearing on government functions there. I thought that was interesting. Somebody feed that guy. They were talking about surveillance, and here he was eating his ear wax. Apparently they're out of funding and he's hungry. From the BBC.com, Puerto Rico arrests priest charged of child sexual abuse. Now, when a priest rapes your children, this is called capacity building. It's maintained and structured through the Federal Reserve program. They get paid nice funds through the 501c3 program, and usually they get a slap on the hand. U.S. federal authorities in Puerto Rico have arrested a Roman Catholic priest on charges of sexual abuse of minors. Israel Barrios, 58, is the first priest to be detained over charges of this kind in Puerto Rico, a U.S. territory. He is accused of sexually abusing an altar boy and faces a minimum of 10 years in jail if found guilty. Well, what's that? What is that? Let's talk about tricking children out, where a judge charges a priest and the judge cashes in and the prosecuting attorney cashes in on the rape of a child. The national state cashes in on the rape of the child. The federal state cashes in on the rape of a child. And your child is just raped by one of its agents and actors in a capacity building program called Pyongyang. It's called North Korea. Through the Federal Emergency Management Act, you are the states of emergencies. States referring to the state of being. You live in North Korea. It's a concept. It's all tied up by the clearinghouse to discharge congressional bankruptcy. A judge takes an oath under 28 U.S.C., which is the Judiciary Act, subsection 453, to discharge congressional bankruptcy using you. Part of the capacity building is abusing you, getting you assaulted, rear-ending you, ensuring that you have one car accident, burning down your houses, killing you. That's what's required to maintain death derivatives. You can look this up on Google. Death derivatives. A treaty is an agreement between two banks. All of these treaties are agreements between two or more banks to discharge congressional bankruptcy. They've been doing this since Articles of Confederation, Article 12. The United States of being human beings are charged and pledged to discharge that debt. Part of the process of being in the Pyongyang Project is a debenture participation program. It's a debt secured by your own earning power. You are farm animals. You can find you listed under the Agriculture Act, Title 7 of U.S. Code. So when a priest rapes your children and they get charged for it, that is called capacity building. Revenue is being generated into their coffers. Instead of removing that priest from the ability to harm your children, they will put it in prison and play catch and release so that it's guaranteed to do that again. That priest did not rape just one child. It's a priest. Its function is to rape as many as it can before it's caught. Its function is to induct females. If you go and research, and do your own research on this one, how many nuns are inducted by the same process? Rape by the priests. They go on to rape children. The most prolific child sexual abuser is the female. You can find these numbers in the United Nations Report on Human Trafficking 2009. The United Nations, each foreign nation, as defined under 28 U.S.C. subsection 1603, is a county, is a corporation. The United Nations Report on Human Trafficking 2009 are their financial documents. They are telling you what they do. They are telling you how much money they make. They are telling you why policy says that they present to you that males are the main perpetrator of abuse. In reality, according to the UN itself, the female, psychopathic female, is the most prolific abuser of children. Other females and the slave labor market across the globe. Now, all of this time, before they were held accountable, Eve has been running around doing everything that she wants to. Under feminism, she was specialized to rape your kids. Under feminism, she was specialized to kill you, to kill children. Childwelfare.gov puts out every year that the mother or female murders about 1,200 children a year. Children, as defined by attorneys. That word child There is another 35,000 per year in the United States incorporated alone that are not deemed to be children. These murders are called infanticide and neonaticide. And altogether, there's almost 38,000 children, babies, murdered each and every year by psychopathic females. Those aren't listed. Because if you knew what was going on, you would be in an uproar. You would look around at your schools and realize that they've loaded the schools up with female employees. You would realize that the daycares that you hear about now, raping children, killing children, they're all filled up with female employees. There's a purpose for that. It's called genocide. And again, I urge everybody to go read Rummel's research on democide. You'll notice one thing very interesting in his research. He does not include the United States Incorporated. This is what allowed him to have his research at hawaii.edu. Otherwise, it would have been taken down a long time ago. If you knew that Patrick Leahy was killing your kids, if you knew that Joseph Biden wrote the Violence Against Women Act so that he could prey on females and children, if you knew that Patrick Leahy authored the Crimes Against Children Act as a privacy law so that children could be preyed on by legislators, attorneys, judges, bankers, psychiatrists, teachers, priests, counselors, and all of the other actors and agents that maintain corporate welfare according to the first and second welfare theorems. From actionnewsjax.com, school nurse charged with student medication theft. Lake City, Florida. A school nurse was arrested Tuesday afternoon after reportedly taking medication from a student. Marley Boozer, 24, is charged with theft and possession of a controlled substance, according to Columbia County Sheriff's Office Deputy Murray Smith. At the request of the Columbia County School Board, the investigation into the Pine Mount Elementary School nurse began Friday after a parent reported to the school that some of their child's medication was missing. Boozer had submitted her letter of resignation, as it is on the school board's Tuesday night agenda. She's being held at the Columbia County Detention Facility on $5,000 bond. Why are you still medicating your children? That's what I want to know. From the StarTribune.com, pedophile teacher abused scores as clues missed, killed himself in Minnesota. He was one of the most beloved teachers in the small world of international schools that serve the children of diplomats, well-off American expatriates, and local elites. He was often the first to arrive in the morning and the last to leave each day. He led students on class trips to exotic places, treating them to cookies and milk at bedtime. That was the public persona of William Bay he carefully crafted over four decades until a maid cleaning his home in Nicaragua stole a 16-gigabyte memory drive. There, in a photograph after photograph, was evidence that the model teacher had molested scores of adolescent boys, possibly far more, in a career spanning 10 schools in four continents. The FBI said last month at least 90 boys were in the images on the memory drive. The Bureau said Tuesday that it has now been contacted by several hundred individuals from around the globe wishing either to reach out as potential victims or provide information in the ongoing investigation. This says that he was investigated before for this very thing. Nothing ever came of it. He was very, very, very efficient at maintaining national security in the capacity building project, making sure that your children are broken, making sure that children from broken homes are raped and used in various ways, like pets or saddle horses. Which is the concept of education alone. Education stems from the word pedagogy, meaning attendance on boys. In a relative sense, that is the metaphor of removal of the firstborn son. If a male child is abused by a male predator, it's worse than if he was abused by a female. Creates that lost soul. Feeling of lost power and gives the state the ability to use and manipulate that child for the rest of their lives as they act out and cry out for help. Parents don't believe their children when they try to speak out. They take them to the psychiatrist when they act out, which is another predator, or the school counselor, which is another predator. Or you take them out to the priest to confess their sins. Call them little boys, babies, bad boys for what they're doing as they act out and cry out to be saved from these monsters. It's filthy, abhorrent against God. This is what the system is. This is what it does. Secretary of State is a clearinghouse maintaining the capacity building venture. It's a mutual voyage according to their bank charters from the 1600s. This is part of child trafficking. If you keep them in school, I will hold you accountable for allowing your children to be abused at this point in time, because with knowledge, you have the choice. Oh, but Tammy, I have to work. No. You have an obligation to your children. Oh, but I can't. You have an obligation to your children. If you have children, they're your first priority. You don't need shiny things. You don't need anything, as nothing is more important than those children. And I'll tell you right now, you will be held accountable just as much as the others if you put them in those situations. We just saw females being charged last week for selling their children to pedophiles. Enough is enough. I will not tolerate these things. From the ChicagoTribune.com, ex-Israeli leader Ehud Olmert sentenced to 6 years for bribe-taking. Reporting from Jerusalem. One of Israel's highest-profile court cases ended Tuesday with a scathing critique of public corruption, harsh jail sentences, and a former prime minister sent to prison, effectively ending Ehud Olmert's decades-long political career. Olmert was found guilty in late March of 2 counts of accepting bribes as part of a massive real estate scam known as the Holy Land Affair. Scandal took its name from a Jerusalem housing development, a linked chain of high-rise apartment towers that initially stirred controversy on aesthetic and environmental grounds. Prosecutors later charged that the approval and building process had been marred by widespread irregularities and corruption. This is what the United States Incorporated does. It moves in with development grants. You know, it's the one that funds Monsanto through development grants. You can find all of these things at grants.gov. You can find information on how they're granting and funding cloud seeding. Just search for development grants. And you'll see everything that they do. Core drilling is one of the most important things that any one of you can look up and research. as well as the Dussel coil itself, that is the cause of, quote, earthquake activity and, quote, volcanic activity around the globe. So you'll find these geophyses out there core drilling, and it appears to be sampling, but they have an ulterior motive. The Corps of Engineers, of course, is at the head of many of these schematics. That's their function, geoengineering. All of these things are written. So now the PM, as a fall guy for the United States Incorporated, and I'll continue reading. The project began during Olmert's tenure as mayor of Jerusalem in the 1990s. He was elected prime minister in 2006 and announced his resignation in 2008 amid separate corruption allegations, but remained in office until elections were held in 2009. He ultimately was tried and acquitted on those charges, which included allegations that he accepted thousands of dollars in cash stuffed envelopes from an American businessman, the United States Incorporated, or if you'd rather, the United Nations. On Tuesday, Olmert, 68, was sentenced to 6 years in prison in order to pay a $290,000 fine. Six others, among them Jerusalem's former city engineer, a sitting city councilman, and a business entrepreneur, were sentenced to jail terms between 3 and 8 years in order to pay hefty fines. Several others convicted of taking or offering bribes, including Yuri Lupolianski, who succeeded Olmert as mayor, are to be sentenced in coming days. Judge David Rosen's harsh sentences were accompanied with equally harsh words. Quote, a public official accepting bribes is akin to a traitor, end quote, he wrote. Well, the judge is the banker. He's not going to lose. So sorry, Fall Guys. Perhaps charges against the banker are in order. Or perhaps foreclosing on the court or the bank itself as a mechanism for Congress is in order, as they are commissioned through the 1789 Judiciary Act to use human beings as prostitutes under the Debenture Participation Program, stemming from Article 12 of the Articles of Confederation. And again, Confederacy, defined in Black's Law Dictionary itself, maintains that that is a criminal enterprise. The Australian Federation, Russian Federation, you get where I'm going here? The United Kingdom, the United Nations, the League of Nations, just prior to that. League is a synonym to Confederacy. It's all the same thing. It all has the same board of governors over it, same media, same education or pedagogy, same democide. Same genocide, which means killing of the mind. Not just killing of a human being, it's killing of the mind and soul. It's where the word gen stems from. And of course, this can only happen within patriotism, calling it your father, having a fictional government wherein you can be held as prisoner of war by corporations inside holding companies as negotiable instruments, as per Andrew 2D bills and notes. The law merchant went from being the law merchant to the Negotiable Instrument Act, and that was replaced by UCC, which is Uniform Commercial Code. Now, for all those that are buying into various concepts, mainly Donna Ray, filing the UCC-1 document is a deposit slip. Signing the back or endorsing it with the word special deposit says that they can't cut your arms and legs off to make you more aerodynamic, but they can do anything else they want to you, including every force available under fourth generation warfare, asymmetric warfare, low intensity conflict. And all of this will be given to you on a little plate with flowers on it, called the action or war tactic of hearts and minds. So as they kill you, they'll offer you Social Security benefits, welfare benefits, veterans benefits. You can study this by reading a very, very succinct article called Sticks and Carrots and Procurement. They dangle that little carrot at you, and if you take it, you're theirs. Kind of like a prison setting itself. A lot like a prison setting itself. And again, this is Leaving the Farm. I was so saddened to read about the death of R.J. Rummel tonight. And normally I'm in a much more upbeat mood, of course, now that we are foreclosing on the United States Incorporated. And I was very disheartened to read about his death. It threw me for a loop today. From Bloomberg.com, ex-Lehman banker Magnoni is arrested in Milan probe. Ruggero Magnoni, a 31-year Lehman Brothers Holdings Incorporated veteran, was arrested along with his brothers and a nephew in Milan today amid allegations they siphoned funds from a company that went bankrupt. Well, that sounds familiar. 1933, Congress came in and said, oh, I'll be the trustee over my own bankruptcy. And ever since then, human beings have been tricked out again. It's just now warming up, folks. In the next proverbial hour, all hell will break loose. Now, we tried to limit their liability. We tried to reach them. We said, look, you're doing this. You're doing this, 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 and this. And with notice, they continued to do those things. With knowledge. That is the definition of intent. That crime has already been committed with knowledge and a forethought. And now all that's left is accountability. I'll continue reading. Magnoni is under house arrest for his role as a de facto director of SOPAF, SPA, an Italian merchant bank, from which the manager and his siblings took assets valued at more than 100 million euros, or 138 million FRNs, according to a police official with direct knowledge of the case who asked not to be identified in line with policy. A lawyer for Magnoni, 63, declined to comment on the arrest. He is also facing allegations of International Criminal Association and diverting funds to Luxembourg and the island of Madeira, the official said. One of the transactions being reviewed is a 1 million euro 2006 financing for a South African company, Newman Lowther and Associates, that converted into the company's equity in 2011, the official said. Newman Lowther is a corporate finance and merger advisor that started an exclusive partnership with Nomura Holdings 8604 Incorporated in 2009, according to Ben Lowther, a co-founder of the company. excuse me. Quote, the investment was made to help us develop the business in South Africa, and quote, Lowther said by telephone today. Neither Newman Lowther nor its executive have been accused of any wrongdoing, the police officer said. Officials at Nomura in London declined to comment on the arrest in the partnership with Newman Lowther. Mignotti joined Nomura from Lehman Brothers when Japan's biggest brokerage bought the European operations of the U.S. securities firm out of bankruptcy in 2008. At Lehman, Mignotti helped lead Olivetti S.p.A.'s $34 billion hostile acquisition of Telecom Italia S.p.A. in 1999. Mignotti was employed by Nomura through March of 2013, according to the UK Financial Service Register. Interesting days. Very, very interesting days. From the PressHerald.com, ex-main bank executive accused of using 220,000 FRNs and bank funds at strip clubs. Jeffrey Burnham, 41, who had left TD Bank in 2012, is scheduled to appear in federal court in Portland to face a felony theft charge. A former TD Bank executive in Maine who is accused of spending nearly 220,000 FRNs of the bank's money at strip clubs within a year is scheduled to appear in federal court in Portland this week to face felony theft charges. Jeffrey Burnham, 41, of Arundel, used his TD Bank corporate credit card 72 times at strip clubs in Maine, Massachusetts, New York, and Florida from February 18, 2011 to February 16, 2012, according to bank court records. Burnham, who was vice president and regional mortgage sales manager at the bank's Falmouth office at the time, has been issued a summons to appear in U.S. District Court on Tuesday morning to make his initial appearance on a charge of theft by a bank officer. If convicted, he will face up to 30 years in federal prison and a fine of $1 million. Burnham left TD Bank in February 2012 after about 14 years with the company and its predecessor, People's Heritage Bank. He went on to work for Kennebunk Savings Bank as senior vice president, overseeing the bank's retail banking operations, but no longer works there. Judas always commits political suicide. He got out. He was taking his retirement. And the local magistrate, or E4, which is a judge, said, nah, Caesar doesn't like it when you have more savings than Caesar. He doesn't like it when there's competition. And this is what's going to happen with all federal and state employees, including teachers, doctors, law enforcement, FBI agents, CIA, attorneys, everybody on state or federal employee. This also includes those who are on welfare, those who are on Social Security, those who are on veterans pay, those who are retired. You are up for grabs. They do not like to lose. Now, this occurred during Nazi Germany, if you want to see how this plays out. If you continue to patronize that thing, it takes you, as it did the state and federal employees during the indemnification of Poland, which you know as Nazi Germany. The Bayer Corporation, the Bayer, B-A-Y-E-R Corporation, came in 1927 through the world courts that are owned by Congress as the Republic of Germany and asked for indemnification against Poland. The court allowed and ordered, yes indeed, that Poland could be indemnified to cut the overhead that the Bayer Corporation was experiencing. Now, Google, Microsoft, Coors, Coca-Cola, IBM, Hellman's, Best Foods, BP, Anheuser-Busch, any kind of bank, that is your corporate government. And when the overhead is too great, and they are not making the money that they are expending on welfare, public, state, federal employee, they start culling the overhead, which means human beings. That's what Nazi Germany was. It didn't have anything to do with racism. The Polish citizen, the Polish public employee, state employee, federal employee, were all overhead. Those that were on welfare, social programs, retirement assets, they were all overhead. History always repeats itself. Same thing happened during Rome. Of course, it was taken down by the use of feminism. The first model of feminism was used in Bolshevik Russia after the French Revolution. It moved into Nazi Germany, what you know as Nazi Germany. It's a perpetual business, corporate structure that feels the pinch of overhead, meaning state, federal employees, those that are on welfare, social benefits, and culls that overhead by simply killing human beings. It's not a good idea to patronize that thing. From Newsnet5.com, corruption charges filed against Youngstown Mayor, Mahoning County Auditor, and local attorney. Cleveland, Ohio, Youngstown Mayor John A. McNally, Mahoning County Auditor Michael V. Sciortino, and local attorney Martin Yvorkic have been indicted on criminal corruption charges. The indictments were announced in a joint news conference Wednesday by Cuyahoga County Prosecutor Timothy McGinty, whose office served as special prosecutor in the case, and Ohio Attorney General Mike DeWine. DeWine's Bureau of Criminal Investigation, let's call them ringers, shall we, assisted in the criminal probe along with agents of the Federal Bureau of Investigation. McNally, Sciortino, and Yovorkic have been charged with criminal conspiracy charges in connection with the investigation. McNally was charged in a 34-count indictment that includes engaging in corrupt activity, conspiracy, bribery, and theft in office. Sciortino faces 23 counts involving corrupt activity, conspiracy, and bribery. And Yvorkic faces 27 counts, including tampering with records, bribery, and money laundering. McNally served as Mahoning County Commissioner from 2005 to 2012 and won the general election to serve as mayor of Youngstown on November 3, 2013. He's a 91 graduate of Georgetown University and received a Juris Doctor and Master's in Public Administration in 96. And that is nice to see him used instead of a useful idiot, as he is a administrator, a director, one who directs Fall Guys normally. It's nice to see that he's being held accountable. Now, this is one of the most beautiful ones I've seen in a while. From the IrishTimes.com, former head of GlaxoSmithKline in China charged with corruption. Investigation reveals firm made billions of yuan from bribing doctors and hospitals. Chinese police have charged the British former head of drug maker GlaxoSmithKline's China business and other senior colleagues with corruption after an investigation revealed the firm had made billions of yuan from schemes that involved bribing doctors and hospitals. U.S. Inc., through the Food and Drug Administration, is the one with contracts with the Freiburg's Ethics Commission to use human beings as human test subjects. Pharmaceutical companies are just under that. In the maintenance of genocide, cutting overhead by allowing you to voluntarily take these things with knowledge. They've always had clean hands under clean hands doctrine because they give you the little slip of paper that says, well, you have a headache, this pill might cause tuberculosis and death if you want a trade-off. You have anxiety? This one's a lung depressant, and one of these days you won't wake up if you don't mind the side effects. You've got to realize what you're ingesting and why. The majority of anxiety is caused by fourth generation warfare applied against you by your government that you're patronizing. Stop calling it your father. And much of that weight lifts from your shoulders, allowing you to simply be. Stop striving to be. Stop listening as it tells you that you're naked in your own garden and then sells you your clothes that it says you can wear. That snake is very, very, very tricky. And in that, when you're contracting with it and you're consuming concepts from the tree of knowledge, participating or partaking, eating it up, you are actually the whore of Babel. Now it says, Revelation 18, that at some point you're going to stop consuming from the tree of knowledge. And at that point, the law merchants will. GlaxoSmithKline goes bankrupt, finally. The FDA is no longer existent. Codex Alimentarius is no longer existent. And you learn that the majority of commodities, through trick and deception, are very, very easy to find, grow, and cultivate yourself. For example, every day, millions and millions of pounds of rice are purchased in the store. Rice is grass seed. Wild rice is wild grass seed. You, consumers, pay more for wild grass seed than you do for regular grass seed. Wheat is also a grass seed. These things used to grow freely before the United States Incorporated shut up the Kingdom of Heaven and told you that they own it. 1 Corinthians 6 says that God has raised up the Lord God, so shall he raise us up by his own power. The Constitution of the United States Incorporated says that you vested power in Congress, God, and it's time to divest that power and stop asking it to represent you and sell you, such as wild grass seed or regular grass seed or puffed grass seed. dried grass seed, or something along those lines, as it commoditizes everything, sells it back to you, something that once grew freely. As you step away from the Lord God, Congress, which the word means with transgression, Congress, you realize many, many things that you're capable of. And you are no longer consumed by each other or Eve's children. Cain always consumes ability. You get where we're going here? Because it's very imperative that you stop calling that thing your father now. That thing is killing you, as it has done since the inception of Polycratis, or controlling and possessing many that you know as politics, or the practice of law. All of these things get easier and easier and easier to deal with, not only physically, but mentally. Once you realize all of the force and pressure upon you has been promoted by such as the IMF controlling the inflation rate, controlled by Congress, the International Monetary Fund. The IMF controls the scarcity of all known currencies. Well, when the U.S. Inc. controls the scarcity of currency and it controls the scarcity of commodities, it controls humanity itself. All it takes is stop calling it your father. Stop patronizing it. Because as you patronize it, it grows. Once you stop patronizing it, Revelation 18, the law merchants wail. All of the kings of the earth and all of these well-to-do folks, they're the ones that cry. They're the ones that feel the pinch. They're the ones that are charged with corruption, etc., etc., etc. And it should be, as that is Satan. Satan defined from the etymology means adversary, one who plots against you. Well, Congress is controlling the inflation rate, and Congress is controlling the commodities market, and all of these attorneys are cashing in on your demise, then that's the evidence that Satan, the one who plots against you, is evidently Congress and attorneys. And not some red guy with horns and animated on some television program teaching you what to view as your adversary. The BBG has control of all civil media. We'll be right back, folks. Stick around. Hi, and welcome back to the second hour of Leaving the Farm right here on Revolution Radio, freedomslips.com, where information never sleeps. We are a listener-supported radio station, and if you'd like to donate, please visit us at www.freedomslips.com and click on our support pages. Every little bit helps. We are also simulcasting live tonight on No Borders Radio at noborders.co.uk, as well as one of our newest stations joining us is Tyrannosaur, Land of the Free. And you can find that at www.tirnasaor.com. Sorry about that, everybody. Thank you, everybody, for allowing us this venue. It is so important, especially now. We're getting there. We got news yesterday that Rocco's doing well. Our deputy has given us the news, and hopefully soon I'll be hearing him on the air. It's just right now is a very important time as low-key attorneys and agents that are fall guys are very, very ticked off that they lost. And of course, their handlers are not sharing specific information, including my location. I have had the most interesting couple weeks. The administration, the handlers, the number ones, such as Joseph Biden and John Kerry, Brennan of the CIA, they know exactly where I'm at. All these attorneys have been falling over themselves trying to locate me. And it's very, very interesting to see that evidently they are indeed the fall guy and have not gotten that notice yet. If you don't know where I am, that means that you're the fall guy. Just a little heads up. Because as everybody knows, especially you attorneys, when you sue somebody and when you win and you're collecting on that suit, that somebody has notice. You know, of course, I have to sue them. I have to serve them and let them know where to bring my money. And it's been interesting. So a few weeks ago, I turn on my cell phone and it says there's Bluetooth on there. I don't own a Bluetooth. I'm very simple. So of course I took that application off and I turned off the Bluetooth. I went to use it today and I got a message from Verizon that says I need to register my whatever it was on there. So the battery is out now and I'm still laughing. Because if you have to surreptitiously locate me, again, you're the fall guy, sadly. So, that being said, I am not your enemy. Your peers are. You need to realize this and realize this quickly. Because political cannibalism sucks. That's when you lose everything in an hour. It's not me who takes it. It's the other pedophile that knows what you've been doing. The one with all the information against you that's going to roll on you before they get taken down. That's what the game of politics is. And you wanted to play it. And here we are. So, from the buffalo.twcnews.com, case moves forward against former nursing supervisor. Buffalo, New York, a grand jury indicted a former nursing supervisor charged with distributing prescription drugs out of her office in Sisters Hospital. The grand jury indicted Catherine Vitello of Elma on four counts Wednesday, including prescription drug distribution. In October of 2013, federal prosecutors said Vitello, the nursing director for St. Catherine Labor Healthcare Center, sold more than 140 oxycodone pills and fentanyl patches to a source that was working for investigators. If convicted, Vitello faces up to 20 years in prison and fines up to $1 million. She works for a hospital. She's up for grabs as overhead. Somebody else had information. Somebody else was an informant. One of her peers that sparked this, quote, investigation. That is what political cannibalism is. I don't know anything about you. I know your function. I know what you do according to your functions. But it's your peers who have all of that information. Photographs, audio recordings, video recordings, hint, hint, Mayor Ford, and others. And instead of trying to find me, which doesn't help you, we already won the case. So you can kill me like 10,000 times and it doesn't change anything. you're still being foreclosed on. You still owe that money, and your peers are going to still cannibalize you. Self-defense and logic says that you might want to cannibalize your peer first. And you can read about how you fall down in Matthew 27. As for so long you, Judas, or the one with law, an Anglo-Saxon, have been delivering up Jesus. In German or Greek and Latin, Jesus means your earth. And so in that function, you might want to take a look at who takes you out, because Matthew 27 doesn't say Tammy. It doesn't say Rocco. It doesn't say Bo. This is the chief priests and elders, which are your handlers. The elders in the community, of course, are the main players, the corporations with big money. And the priests are usually psychiatrists, priests, pastors, and those on the general council, who aren't necessarily corporate council, but the directors. If you're not a director, you're a fall guy. And again, the way to tell if you're a fall guy or not is if you have to find me. And that's something that's so profound to my mind, is that I could care less what you do to me. It's over. My function was to save the children. I did that. My function is done. So again, it doesn't matter how many times you kill me. It doesn't change the outcome. And at this point in time, you need to start thinking about your offense or defense. And if you are innocent, get out of that situation. Because I really don't like collateral damage at all. Speaking of, from the BostonGlobe.com, wife of Telex Free co-owner arrested at JFK Airport. Now, this is a funny one because everybody knows how well Shaking Down Eve works. The wife of Telex Free owner, Incorporated co-owner Carlos Wensler was arrested at JFK International Airport on Wednesday night as she tried to board a flight to leave the country and join her husband in Brazil, according to the U.S. Attorney's Office. Now, if everybody remembers, we covered this last week, and, you know, he took off. And apparently he thought it was a good idea to leave his wife here in the courts of the United States Incorporated, which is always a good idea to tick off Eve, leave her to face the brunt of things. And I'll continue reading. So, Katja B. Wensler was arrested on a material witness warrant. Everybody knows how that's going to end up, said Christina Sterling, the U.S. Attorney's spokeswoman. She was scheduled to appear in federal court in Brooklyn, New York, Thursday afternoon. Her husband has already fled to Brazil and is considered a fugitive by federal authorities. An affidavit filed in court Thursday detailed a multi-day odyssey in which Carlos Wensler managed to leave the United States. On April 15th, the day his Marlboro-based company office was raided by federal agents investigating an alleged $1 billion global fraud, Wensler and his daughter, Livia, drove to Canada in the family's BMW. They crossed the border at 11 p.m. at Lacolle, Quebec. 2 days later, the father and daughter boarded an Air Canada flight from Toronto to Sao Paulo, Brazil. Wensler entered the country of his birth using a Brazilian passport. That same day, as federal agents executed a warrant to search Wensler's Northboro home, Katya told them her husband was staying at a hotel on the advice of his lawyer. Wensler's business partner, James Merrill, was arrested last week and is in custody pending a detention hearing in Worcester on Friday. Katya Wensler's name surfaced in the Telex Free fraud investigation after a check made out to her was seized by federal agents at the company's local office. According to the affidavit, significant sums of money were moved from Telex Free Bank accounts into a Wells Fargo account in the name of Katia Wentzler. On February 28th, two transfers to her account totaled $3.5 million, according to the affidavit. Subsequently, $1.5 million of that was moved into a Wells Fargo brokerage account bearing her name. In April, just days before Telex Free would file for federal bankruptcy protection, Katia Wentzler allegedly traveled with her husband's business partner, Merrill, to fetch more than $27 million FRNs and cashier's checks from a Wells Fargo bank in Connecticut. Most of those checks were made payable to Telex Free entities, but one of them, for over $2 million FRN, was made out to Katia B. Wentzler. The Wentzler's daughter actually returned to the U.S. recently before leaving again. On April 26, Livia Wentzler flew to Boston on a round-trip ticket using her father's frequent flyer miles. She was scheduled to return to Brazil on June 4th, but instead left on May 1st for Italy. On May 13th, investigators said in their affidavit, someone in Brazil bought Katia a one-way ticket there, paying in cash. The BMW Carlos Wentzler and his daughter drove to Canada, had a license plate registered to Axeris Realty Agency, where Katia is a registered agent, according to the affidavit. Now, she dabbles in real estate, which is human beings. So this ought to be fun, and everybody should really pay attention to this one, because it's only the beginning. Only the beginning. From scmp.com, dissatisfied anti-graft chief orders officials to ramp up corruption crackdowns. The mainland's top anti-corruption official, Wang Qishan, has urged all central government departments and state-owned companies and financial institutions to strengthen efforts to combat graft, signaling his dissatisfaction with their current campaigns. Wang has chaired four meetings on anti-corruption and the top leaders of these departments and companies in the past week, the Central Commission for Discipline Inspection said on its website yesterday. Wang said that they must protect the Communist Party's image and seek to increase rather than decrease its credibility. Quote, don't forget your party position and responsibilities, end quote, Wang said, urging them to do more than, quote, pay attention to business, end quote. He also pledged to punish officials who fail to closely supervise and control the conduct of their staff. So, again, to all of you potential Fall Guys out there, he's speaking to your handlers and warning them that something's up, just as much as Holdren did the other day when he maintained that a certain bank is going to be charged over and over and over again. He's telling your handlers to get out of the way. Now, this means that they're going to start picking off the little guy. I really don't want to see the little guy picked off. If you are innocent, let us know. Get out of there. And remember, I'm not your enemy. Your peers are. Your handlers are. It's very, very important for you to get this through your heads, because I don't want to see you fall. And apparently you are all over. From the TimesFreePress.com, ex-Murray County Chief Magistrate indicted on federal charges. This is a county judge, a little Caesar there. After nearly 2 years under federal investigation, prosecutors today indicted former Murray County, Georgia Chief Magistrate Bryant Cochran for conspiring to plant drugs on his accuser's car. Cochran was indicted on charges including conspiracy to distribute a controlled substance, depriving his employees of their rights, and tampering with a witness. These charges stem from accusations that Cochran devised a plan to plant drugs on Angela Garmley's car. Garmley's complaint that Cochran had pressured her for sex in his judge chambers launched a state ethics complaint that led to Cochran's resignation in August of 2012. Cochran has also been charged with harassing his employees and searching their cell phones without permission. Attorney McCracken Poston, who represented Gomley and the three female employees harassed said the government has made a first step towards justice. Quote, now that the government has finally made federal criminal charges against a former judge, we look forward to watching Mr. Cochran avail himself of each and every constitutional right and privilege that he wanted to deny my clients, end quote. It's just funny. It's advertisements for government protecting its citizens rather than predation. From the couriermail.com.au, administrative charge with $1 million theft from Bani Yule and District's Netball Association. A former administrator has been charged with stealing more than $1 million from a netball association she founded. Christine Melnikas appeared before the Melbourne Magistrates Court over more than $1.2 million allegedly stolen from Bani Yule and District's Netball Association. It's alleged the 53-year-old stole 646,566 FRNs between 2007 and 2012 and the rest after 2012. A complete listing of charges was not released to the media. Police allege stolen funds were deposited into Ms. Melnikas's bank account. Court documents claim Ms. Melnikas took property belonging to the BDNA and also submitted false documentation under the guise of a Netball Victoria official in order to receive additional payments as a Netball Australia Level 2 accredited coach. Ms. Melnikas will appear in court on July 8th. Reappear in court. Interesting. From kpbs.org, feds charge Qualcomm managers with insider trading. Two former Qualcomm Incorporated managers were criminally charged with insider trading for allegedly buying shares of a semiconductor maker before Qualcomm announced an agreement to buy the company. Derek Cohen, 51, and Robert Herman, 52, allegedly used confidential company information to purchase shares in Atheros Communications Incorporated on January 4, 2011, hours before news of the pending acquisition was reported by the New York Times. Qualcomm, a wireless technology titan, bought Atheros for $3.1 billion FRNs. Cohen, Herman, and another former Qualcomm manager, Michael Fleishy, 43, were also charged with insider trading by the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission. Excuse me. Cohen, a sales director for North America who joined Qualcomm in 1995, profited 205,375 FRNs from illegal trade on Atheros shares, according to the SEC. Herman, also a sales director for North America who joined the company in 2007, allegedly profited 29,318 FRNs from illegal trades. Flashy, a regional sales manager for North America who joined Qualcomm in 2007, profited 3,007 FRNs, according to the SEC. Qualcomm, based in San Diego, fired all three defendants in September for violating company policy on insider trading. Aww. Their 401k went away and all that stuff. Somebody's trying to cash in. Somebody found a fall guy. You see where this is going, folks? If you read the case, you can find that world court case. It was called the Company at Churzao. You can find that by going to the world courts. It's Congress's courts. Everything's written. It was Bear Corporation that came in as the Republic of Germany to indemnify Poland. Now, in the United States Incorporated, they already had set in place that little dealio with the 1802 Indemnification Convention. At that point in time, human beings were already indemnified in 1802 starting. Not only did they set up their commission states, which is what the 1802 Indemnification Convention was, but that set off the Acts of Enablements that you know as state constitutions, allowing corporations to indemnify the human being. From tribtown.com, Delaware doctor charged in Silk Road drug sales case agrees to enter a guilty plea. Wilmington, Delaware, a Delaware doctor accused of participating in illegal drug sales on the underground website known as Silk Road has decided to enter a guilty plea in federal court. Alexandra Gold had entered a plea of not guilty in January after her public defenders had indicated they were working with prosecutors to try to resolve the case without a trial. But a judge on Wednesday scheduled a June 11th hearing at which Gold will plead guilty. Gold and her fellow gynecologist and live-in partner, Dr. Olivia Bolis, were charged with maintaining a dwelling for drugs after federal agents in Florida tracked shipments of drugs bought on the website in Delaware. Gold was suspended from her position as an instructor at Johns Hopkins University Medical School in Baltimore after her arrest. Suspended, not fired. They're waiting for everything to cool down. Because, you know, Gelnhausen Charters is whatever you see, you're going to forget in a minute anyway. It's just sick. Absolutely. Deplorable. Doctors. You're still patronizing it as it kills you and offers you all sorts of prescriptions. Look at that word, folks. Prescription. Writing before you are. It alters your heading. From the SunHerald.com today, this is breaking. Jackson doctor charged in death of wife. Jackson, Mississippi. A Jackson ophthalmologist has been charged with murder in the fatal shooting of his wife at their home on Wednesday night. Jackson Police Department spokeswoman Colindula Green says 68-year-old Dr. William Mayfield was denied both during an appearance in municipal court Thursday. Green says Mayfield is charged with murder in the death of 67-year-old Susan Mayfield. Susan Mayfield died at a local hospital. Green says it appears the shooting was the result of an argument. We'll get updates probably by Saturday on that one. It seems like this is a going theme, I guess, today. From Newsday.com, prosecutors, wife of Baldwin doctor and painkiller probe charged with tax fraud. So apparently it looks like they're shaking her down now, too. The wife of a Baldwin doctor charged with illegally prescribing thousands of painkillers in exchange for $1.4 million FRNs in cash has been charged in connection with her husband's case, prosecutors said. Bibi Shazida Perswad, 42, is charged with criminal tax fraud and offering a false instrument for filing in the first degree. She faces up to 4 years in prison if convicted. Prosecutors said she filed false tax records along with her husband, Dr. Anand Perswad, 45, who improperly issued thousands of prescriptions for oxycodone and other drugs in exchange for cash payments in 2011 and 2012. Both pleaded not guilty Thursday in Nassau County Court to charges leveled in a new indictment. Bibi Perswad was released without bail and ordered to surrender her passport. Her husband remains jailed on $500,000 FRN bond or $250,000 cash bail, records show. Quote, for a doctor, a trusted licensed professional to violate his professional duties and use his position to traffic in narcotics is unconscionable, end quote, New York Attorney General Eric T. Schneiderman said in a statement. Quote, that he and his wife also failed to report their total income is also a crime. My office will seek to keep New York patients safe from rogue doctors and protect our tax dollars. Well, no, that's commercial crimes, 27 CFR 72.11. He was outside of the original agreement, which says he's going to promote addiction in his patients. And on the side, he was making money on the side. And under 27 CFR 72.11, that means that he was undercutting the federal government. So Mr. Schneiderman is just charging him for undercutting the federal government, not that he was killing humans or anything. These things are horrifying. And the sooner you realize who you're patronizing, the sooner these things end and you stop being used as farm animals. Colony means farm or landed estate. Sorry about that, folks. I just lost my... Everything kind of shut down on me. Wow. Okay. for a minute anyway. I'll get this. I had one loaded up. It was Illinois, and now I'm not seeing it. Let me go. Sorry about that, folks. Trying it. It's a slow internet or something. Just 1 second here. It's an interesting story.
Yeah, you didn't pay your priority internet access fee.
Yeah, Qualcomm's.
You're not a corporation, so yeah. You can't have that. The general welfare clause be damned.
The managers at Qualcomm aren't there anymore. They got arrested, so now we're getting crappy internet service. From abcnews.go.com, ex-Chicago official charged in red light program. Federal authorities Wednesday arrested a retired Chicago official who managed one of the nation's largest red light camera programs, accusing him of accepting hundreds of thousands of dollars in cash, an Arizona condominium, and other gifts to steer 124 million FRNs in city contracts to Phoenix-based Redflex Traffic Systems Incorporated. After allegedly fixing a key commission vote to secure an initial $25 million deal, John Billis, now 52, attended a celebratory dinner and made clear it was time for him to be paid by Redflex for delivering the contract, a 28-page complaint says. 28-page complaint. Chicago awarded that contract to Redflex in 2003 and signed others later for the city's first red light enforcement program, which uses cameras to automatically record and ticket drivers who run red lights. After 32 years with the city, Billis retired in 2011 as managing deputy commissioner of the Transportation Department. The latest accusation of bribery is just another page in a long ignominious history for Chicago and Illinois. Multiple Chicago City Council members have been convicted of corruption, and the state's previous two governors, one Democrat and one Republican, were also convicted on corruption-related charges. I love this story, Bo. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
There's no bipartisanship. They're all criminal enterprise.
Right.
What do you think about all this news about cannibalism and all of these things? I mean, it's so profound, and again, you know, it's just now, it's all over but the crying. My grandma used to say that, it's all over but the crying. You know,
well, I don't mind seeing these entities go down. I just pray that no innocents get in harm's way because over aggressiveness of law enforcement or whatnot. And we've already seen that play out with the citizens, how the citizens are just beaten to a pulp and killed and maimed, blinded, tased to death. Prison guard slammed an inmate that was in there for a misdemeanor and killed him. You know, what comes around goes around, though. I guess I wouldn't mind seeing that same aggressiveness used on some of these entities that are really deserving of such.
Yeah, attorneys, GALs. GALs deserve the greatest weight and damnation for what they've done. County conservators, guardians, they're all the same thing, and they've always maintained large amounts of revenue by trafficking in children. And it was very beautiful last night to hear on your show you did some breaking news regarding a GAL that actually got more time than her husband. So she's not being specialized as a female, and she's not being specialized as a GAL either, which was, it was very beautiful to hear.
Finally, what is that? That the first one ever?
I believe so. I've never seen it happen because I've been after them forever. I mean, that's one of my functions is to go after who's trafficking children. And I've seen, when I was in Ohio a few years ago, I went after one GAL, and then they appointed a GAL for that GAL, and then they appointed another GAL for that GAL, and they're untouchable up until now because they have quasi-judicial status.
Well, it couldn't happen to a nicer bunch. They've been human trafficking, they got caught, they've been committing genocide, they got caught, called them on it. And this is over. People just stand up and realize who they are. Now, I've been catching a few stories here and there on these fires being started. 7 out of 8 are reported in California to have been started by unnatural causes.
Absolutely. Guarantee insurance. They've been doing that for years. The reason they targeted Jeffrey and Erica Henderson years ago and took all of their children and kept them busy for the last, 7, 8 years was because they actually videotaped sheriff's deputies, detectives lighting the wildfires. They caught them on video, and ultimately they were thrown off the track, you know, and kept busy because they were fighting for their kids and, you know, under fourth generation warfare. I mean, they've gone through hell and back. And the saddest thing was at the rock bottom, they eventually went over to their church. And so they're relying on that Jewish rabbi and all those things. So the law enforcement back then, the detectives, FBI agents, were never held accountable because they kept them busy. But that is guarantee insurance. That's what the corporation does.
And it's directed by the same people that you love to vote for, you people who vote, those, so your city council or, they come in various different brand names, but they're all corporate council attorneys that run your local municipalities.
Right.
They direct everything.
Right.
Insurance. They are directing this stuff.
Right. Insurance, real estate agents, real estate brokers.
People like Scott K. Summers.
Yep. And Andrew P. Stewart. You know, these entities, they direct things like that, and the agents work on their behest. And as I've said time and time again, yes, there is accountability for everyone, especially for murder. But if you're a potential fall guy, such as one of these agents, I would rather see your handler go down so that this ends than I would see you go down.
Now, in the mainstream media, they're throwing out the idea of that they've already allocated $1 billion for this year's budget for fighting firefighters.
Right.
Fighting wildfires. And they also said that there's some sort of device that they have already paid for and works beautifully at stopping these wildfires, sitting in Arizona somewhere, but there's no plans to use it.
Absolutely not, because you can only industrialize if you raise a community first, if you burn it to the ground. And we've been watching that in Ohio now this year. A school principal lit one of the schools on fire this year. That was like in North Dakota or something. Then there was insurance agent got nailed, and so did a detective down in Florida for doing the same thing. They were lighting things on fire and flooding people out of their homes to maintain their insurance claims.
This is how your government operates, people that call it your government.
But now they're getting held accountable. And apparently from these new reports on the wildfires out in California, those fall guys didn't get that note. And that's sad because, you know, they're just doing their jobs on a day-to-day basis on behalf of their handlers that are actually cashing in well beyond anything that these low-key detectives and agents ever even imagined. And I can give you a hint, these detectives and others are making 10% of 10% while the handlers are cashing in on the rest.
Yep. They don't teach you this stuff in school. They teach you that you got to vote to be a good citizen for your country.
Right.
Now, have you talked about that Operation American Spring going on? It's scheduled for tomorrow. As many as 1 million people are to march on Washington, D.C.
Is that like the last time when nobody showed up?
Yeah, we'll see what happens, but supposedly some million are scheduled to be there and some 20 million in support on the back end. But there's call for arrests of these politicians for the premise of replacing them with what? Better politicians? They're all politicians. Did you not explain the word politics to them?
Right. And the saddest thing is that, you know, you're choosing always you're given the choice and option of the lesser of two evils. And that is the doctrine of election. You can get a right or a benefit, but never both. And your rights and benefits are already pre-assigned. There's already an exclusionary clause in the doctrine of election. And regardless, you're never, ever, ever, ever getting anything or anywhere. And you're going backwards the whole time. That's the whole premise of Polycrates, controlling and possessing many. And again, we go back to democide, killing people. That's what it comes down to. And no more voting, no more patronizing.
And these headlines like this one here plays right into the paradigm. Rand Paul, colon, my dad lost an election to voter fraud. Oh, woe is me.
Right. And making your dad a victim when he's one of the most prolific criminals out there is just sick.
I bought into the paradigm back in the day, and when I was still voting, voted to Rand Paul, you know.
We all did. We all bought into the beauty at one time. Now that, you know, and it says that in 1 Corinthians 6. Once you realize that all of this stuff is going on and you're a prison and a prison camp already and it's not coming, it's time to put on your big boy pants. When I was a child, I spoke as a child, I thought like a child, and now, you know, I see through this glass darkly. It's very, very hard to look at these things and realize what's going on. However, the promise is in there.
In my defense, your material was not available to me at the time, and there was nobody to tell me anything different.
And it wasn't available to me then either. I was still buying into it.
I wasn't getting this information from Rod Class, Mark Stevens, Gene Keating, even John Stewart. None of that.
I wasn't either. I was still buying into it. And I bought into Rod Class, and I went down to North Carolina just to meet him. And it was just sad. And then, of course, I've met many, 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 many agents. And
Roger Elvick.
Yeah, all of these agents. And they all have a really good spin and really smooth tongues. And we all buy into it until you're no longer able to. Until you have the evidence. This is, excuse me, but this guy's an agent or this girl's an agent.
Every one of these quote-unquote gurus is teaching you to patronize the system in one form or another.
Absolutely. Well, you saw me a couple years ago. I mean, I just love Donna Rae to pieces. You know, she was a victim. She came to me as a victim. And, of course, she was introduced by an agent, but I didn't know he was an agent then. It all ended disastrously because of who she is and what her premise was. What her function was as an agent, and now, you know, in her classes, she's teaching people to deposit themselves into holding corporations using the UCC-1 document and signing the back special deposit. That's sick. That is so twisted. And at one time, you know, I bought into it all. She played the victim really well. When in reality, she's always been an agent. She was never married to Joe Kane or Jerry Kane.
Sometimes it gets very hard to decide in your mind whether they're agents or useful idiots. But either way, they still have the same function.
Absolutely.
It just costs less to to the handlers if they're useful idiots.
Well, the history of Donna Rae, she only knew Jerry Kane 3 months. And then after he was killed, she played that she was his common-law wife and all this stuff. And she went after his estate, trying to get his estate in front of his children. Now, that is an agent. And that, I mean, I was so horrified when I realized what she was, because I played into all of it. She played the widow. Well, I'm a widow. They killed my husband back in 2000. And so I played into that for the longest time. And here she is. She's absolutely evil.
I talked to her. I was caught up in the whole thing. It's very hard to delineate sometime with all of them playing their roles. It's just a very sad situation. Because nobody's nobody's teaching you how this thing works and how the pieces fit together over the long spectrum of time. And just as in the Gelnhausen Charter, people forget with the passage of time.
Right. And that's how it's always been. History repeats itself because people forget over passage of time. And that's how they were able to get one over on an entire global society using the House of Representatives, using that marquee itself, and the CIA, the production company for the United States Incorporated. They've sold everybody the Cold War. They sold everybody Vietnam. These are all CIA productions. And then we sent our children over to fight for whatever country. But they all started out as Civil War productions.
Yeah, like this whole thing where, Taiwan or 200... places were burnt to the ground in protest of the Chinese. That's maybe Vietnam. I can't recall one of those Asian quote-unquote countries.
Yeah.
And that's all
CIA.
As it's spelled out in that book.
Right. The book 4 of the Church Committee reports supplementary detailed staff reports on foreign military intelligence. And that's what it's always been. And you can read in there who killed JFK. It was his own brother. He was Secretary of State at that time. It's a form of capacity building. If you traumatize a citizenship and show them, look, your president's dead, they really want a president at that time. They feel that loss. And these actors, they love Reagan. They love JFK. They love these actors. They're beautiful actors. When in reality, JFK was sitting with Bush on the Federal Reserve Board. You know, he wasn't a good guy. He presented as a great guy. But if you look into the history, if you read the Federal Reserve Board writings, the working papers, you can see how the Federal Reserve directs policy, why it directs policy, how it uses human beings to facilitate capacity building. And you know, it's sad because I just lost probably 25% of our listeners when I said JFK was a bad guy. He was sitting on the board of governors at the Federal Reserve.
Well, look, let's just get this out in the open. There is nobody in Congress that is a good guy by the evidence that was brought out in my case where we found them all guilty of human trafficking and genocide.
Right.
End of discussion. I mean, if you want to debate that, go debate the substance of the case.
Right.
Don't say you're crazy.
Right. Find me one politician that's not screwing children or trafficking in females or males.
In the meantime, they're telling you right in some of these headlines what they are. Here's one, USDA to purchase submachine guns. Oh, yeah.
Absolutely. That's right in their contracts with the FDA and the Ethics Commission. Which is Fiji, by the way, the Freiburg's Ethics Commission International, FECI, which is actually, it means to kill the feet. To kill the feet on a farm. Colony means farm or landed estate. Rules of Procedure 2006, the most current Rules of Procedure for the Ethics Commission. You can find that online by simply searching Freiburg's Ethics Commission International, Fiji, and Rules of Procedure 2006, and you'll find that the human being is a human test subject. That's all you are.
They started planting the seed some time ago in the media, years back, about how meat is going to be soaring in prices. Now, recently, we've had all these incidents of livestock being culled off for silly reasons. You know, many thousands of pounds of hot dogs thrown away in that one story.
I was listening to NPR the other day when I was out and about, and they said there's cattle rustlers again. And the same thing with the Bundy Ranch. They're shooting cattle. They're culling cattle. They're culling pork. All of these things, and now, of course, they're going to provide you with the new inflation rate on the commodity of meat. We were talking about commodities in the first hour.
Yeah, now in this headline I read here at Blacklisted News, meat prices surge most in 11 years.
There you go. And that's the reason why. They have to cut the supply to increase the demand.
That's your government, United States Inc., at work for them.
Absolutely. And it's time to stop patronizing it.
FCC approves plan to consider paid priority on internet. Who do you think will benefit? Corporations.
Of course.
The, let's see, State Department refuses to deny Israeli spies on U.S. Feinstein dubious as well.
Dianne Feinstein is the chair of the Senate Intelligence Committee. And, of course, we were talking about John Ford Kerry in the beginning of the first hour. And he is the clearinghouse. So you have those two combined, the CIA, the production company, as well as John Forbes Kerry as the clearinghouse. And you have facilitation of Polycratus to control and possess many. It's part of your government. That means the action of governing.
Another headline, spying is meant to crush citizens' dissent, not catch terrorists.
Yeah.
Of course, the semi-awake people knew that.
And when they're turning your mind away from what the intelligence collection actually is, then that is very concerning. Now, when you go apply for your driver's license, that is intelligence collection. When you take an SAT test, when you fill out a census form, when you apply for welfare, when you apply for Social Security, when you register, when you fill out these questionnaires and Delphi studies, Delphi surveys, whatever, that is intelligence collection. They're asking you for your emotional responses. They're asking you for your political responses, economic responses, and they know everything about you because of you. The NSA is nothing in comparison to what you're providing them, just simply by providing them all of your information on these forms that you fill out on a day-to-day basis.
Talk about the grand chess game, as Brzezinski called it. France thumbs nose at Obama over sanctions. We'll deliver two warships to Russia.
Yeah, the Treaty of Westphalia. France and America and Germany and all the others, Italy, are all called Rome.
1648.
They're all the same thing. That is what Rome is. They're all in bed with each other through the Confederacy. And these things, you know, go look in their charters. Everything is written. There's nothing that I'm saying is new. The sheeple, though, have been trained and taught to gravitate towards human ease. So they're going to run out to the Tim Turners. They're going to run out to the rug classes. They're going to run out to Mark Stevens. They're going to run out to everybody because it's easy to fill out a form and put your blood thumbprint on it or fill out a form and write on the back special deposit when you don't know what it says. That thing says that the U.S. Inc. is the creditor and you're the debtor.
This tells you what they're all about right here. Have you ever given food to a homeless person? Well, if you do it again in the future, it might be a criminal act depending on where you live.
Sick. So I think that we should start that too. Again, you know, I've done that so many times in the past, and we should just all of us start doing that and let them pick us up. They have our fee schedule.
And people say it's too hard. I need this government substance to get by on. Well, what about holding them accountable for abrogating the contract of the General Welfare Clause? If you're so in love with that Constitution, why don't you ever, you know, these people that are constitutionalists, like, never bring out the fact that they abrogated the General Welfare Clause from the get-go.
Right, and what they're not aware of is, you know, Jesus said it so succinctly when he said, take up your cross and follow me. For those who save their own life, they shall lose it. That's what it means. It's only for a brief moment in time. You know, and a lot of people don't realize that. I'm right here. And your version or your definition of suffering is not actual suffering. Suffering is when your body is being harmed. Suffering is not that you can't afford marshmallows in your chocolate milk or hot chocolate or sugar in your tea or something like that. I mean, you have to prioritize what's going on here, people, because you are choosing something that is harming you and your children and cashing in on your demise in exchange for food stamps.
Yeah, and you're working your tail off trying to find a decent job that you can make a decent wage and live with yourself at the same time, while Obamacare contractors are paid to sit at computers and hit the refresh button, according to Lou Dobbs.
Oh, it makes it look like they have more hits on their sites. Isn't that interesting? Because we've seen that too with, you know, they'll put up a YouTube video and all of a sudden it's got 1 million hits. That's what they sit there and do.
Unbelievable how people just keep falling for this stuff over and over again.
But it's the gimmick of the silent weapon. You know, if when the internet slows down, that's a marketing gimmick.
Sure.
The internet slows down. You can't get to the site you were going to learn something or to look something up. So you're going to go play Farmville on Facebook, or you're going to go play a game somewhere else. You're going to take the easier route. And that's what it says in the Gelnhausen Charter. It says, human beings, you're all just idiots. Stop being idiots. All it is human ease. You're choosing your meats wrapped up in plastic rather than hunting. Or your food rather than going out in your own yard and picking it, like we were talking about in the first hour. You know, rice is grass seed, wheat is grass seed. Almost everything in your yard is edible. And some of the most profound things are in your yard. You're calling dandelions weeds, for example. Dandelions are so profoundly good for the liver. It actually detoxifies your body and gets rid of all of these toxins. But you call it a weed and kill it. And then you plant your grass with all these decorations.
Because you've been trained that that's the politically correct thing to do.
Right. And
through politics,
right.
Once again.
Polycratis. And you're not even living in a relative state. You're just living in this fictional independent state. That means you're in a pending state. You're not dead. You're not alive. You're just polycratis. You're in the middle. You're being controlled and possessed. And you're just... Dante Alighieri describes that as purgatory. You're not in hell, the inferno, and you're not in paradise. You're just in this question stage where you're dependent on your government. You're in a pending state. You're not really living. You're kind of just existing in this state. And you'll pay your taxes and you'll do to your day-to-day 40-hour work where you come home, watch television program, get some more programming in you, you know, and then do it again tomorrow. And then you get to get off during the weekends. And, you know, you've got President Woodrow Wilson gave you an extra hour to work under the Daylight Savings Program.
And another example of how they have shut off the kingdom, and that's all these attorneys running your government. This headline reads, our corporations are beyond patent happy to the point now where companies own hundreds of thousands of patents on very basic ideas to the detriment of humanity's progress. That was a story linked at Investment Watch to a video on RT. But this whole idea, this patent ability, is unlawful on its face to begin with. And it's right in your face, all these stories about how they've shut the kingdom off, and they're shutting off continually more and more and more, right in your face in the mainstream media, yet you keep voting for them instead of holding them accountable.
Absolutely. And your children are actually paying for your decisions. We'll be back on Saturday, folks. Thank you for joining me. Well, be well, everybody.
All right. Be well. Take care.